Installing brackets is so simple, I really don't need to walk you through the process. It's the same installation process you would use to install any program on your computer. Just go to the brackets.io page and click on the download link. It should show the correct operating system on the button. If you're a Linux user, you can check out this link down here. There are installation instructions right near the button. The current version is 42. This version will change as I film the course because they usually release a new version every month and it takes me longer than that to create courses. I have installed a clean version so I can show you what happens when you first open it up. If you don't have it installed yet, pause the video and come back when it's installed. When you open up brackets, you'll see that there's already code loaded into the editor. This page gives you a little taste of what brackets can do and it's helpful to read. To actually see the page, you can click on this little flash icon on the right. This is the live preview button. You receive this message only one time. It's telling you that the live preview currently only works with a Chrome browser and that when you have live preview turned on, it will display HTML and CSS changes live. So I'll click on OK and we can see the page in the browser window that pops open. I'll talk more about this live preview in a future lesson. First, I'd like to talk about the workspace a bit so you know what we're looking at. By default, brackets opens up with a sidebar that's here in gray. The important thing to notice here is that the files that are open are shown up at the top. Many editors have tabs on the top going horizontally, but in brackets, your open files are shown right here under Working Files. This Getting Started is the folder you have open. It's part of the brackets install, and you can see the full path of the folder if I hover over the button. If I wanted to open a new folder or project, I can click on it, and it will let me change projects. I'll leave it for now. I'll be discussing opening projects and files in another lesson coming soon. Below this button is a file listing. It's showing all the folders and files that are in the current project. When you click on a file, it's displayed in the editor, but it isn't part of the working file set until I start editing the file or I double-click on it to open it. In the next lesson, we'll talk about how you can customize this workspace to your personal preferences.